I'd like to talk today about the foot, more specifically the midfoot, which is made by a bunch of bones that also have a bunch of joints around them. Now, these joints are meant to move. Keeping them stiff within a shoe only limits the amount of mobility that goes through those joints. And as I've said before in some of my other videos, we need to have healthy joints, and those joints must move through a full range of motion. And that helps bathe the synovial fluid throughout the joint. So how do we get this area moving more? Okay, so what we have to realize is that this midfoot collapses but also produces an arch. So when we look at the foot, we actually have three arches, but for the most part, most people look at the medial arch right here. Okay, there is a lateral arch which isn't as visible, and there's also an arch that goes across the foot. So what we want to be able to do, we want to be able to have our foot collapse down. We also want to have our foot be able to produce an arch. This is so that when we're walking around over uneven surfaces, which we don't do much of it because we're wearing those shoes that have nice hard soles that don't move as much, we want to be able to move them more. So how do we do that? Some people have difficulty even trying to do what I've just done here by creating and producing that. So what we do is, and I'm going to take a step back here, what we do is we rotate one way. As I rotate to my right, there's a natural tendency towards my right foot to start to produce an arch. If I really don't try and hold my foot down, you'll just see it pop up like this. Okay? If you look at the other foot, because I'm rotating to my right, there's a natural tendency for it to want to collapse. Okay? So for me to want to get mobility through the foot is, as I rotate to my right, I'm going to do my darndest to keep my toes down on the ground. And that arch starts to get formed. Okay? It's also taking those muscles in the foot and having them contract. We might actually be exercising those muscles as well as we do this movement. And so as I rotate to my right, I'm producing the arch on the right. As I rotate to the right, my left foot is actually collapsing. So now I can go through and rotate left and right, and I'm producing that arch. This is a nice way to do it, more as a little bit of thoughts involved, but more of a reflex of how the body normally functions to get motion as we walk and whatnot. So that's a nice, quick, easy way to start to work on getting your feet moving more, specifically through the midfoot. Have a great day.